In general, the Ubiquiti Unify cloud key works pretty reliably, but in today's video, I'll show you what to do when it doesn't. The problem with these first-gen cloud keys is that they're susceptible to database corruption if there's a sudden loss of power. When this happens, you might notice that the cloud key's status LED will start flashing with a white light and you can't log into the Unifi controller. And unfortunately, this has happened to me a couple different times, once during a power outage, and another time it just seemed like a random occurrence. But since then, I've learned a couple of different solutions that I'll share with you today that's going to change that flashing white LED back to a blue one. So I'll start with the easiest fix first, which is restarting the Unifi service. And to perform that command, you're going to need to SSH into the cloud key. So up on my screen here, I have a SSH client. If you've never done this in Windows before, you can type in SSH in a PowerShell command prompt. So I've already logged into the cloud key. Once you do that on your end, all you need to do is type in sudo service unify restart. And I sincerely hope that you enjoy me breaking my network so that you can learn how to fix yours. And once the Unifi service restarts, it'll return you back to a flashing command prompt. And if you're lucky, that might be all you have to do. So go over to your cloud key and check the status light and see if it's blue. But unfortunately, if that didn't work, the Mongo database on your cloud key is probably corrupted. You'll need to reset the cloud key back to default and then restore it from a backup file, which I'll go into now. So the first thing we'll need to do is locate our backups. They're going to be stored in the cloud key in the data auto backups directory. So let's go there now and make sure that you have some. So we're just going to CD into data auto backup and then list the files there. And you can see all mine here. So now that we know that we have backups, we actually need to get these off of the cloud key, because when you reset the cloud key, it will clear the file system and you'll lose these files. So since I'm on Windows, I'm going to use a tool called WinSCP to download the backups off the cloud key onto my desktop. So here I've logged into the cloud key. I'm in the root directory. So I'm going to go up and I'm going to go to that data auto backup directory. I can select all my files and download them. Now we can go ahead and close WinSCP and navigate back over to our shell and change into the sbin directory. And inside this sbin directory, we're going to run the ubnt sys tool with command reset to defaults. So the cloud key restore operation takes quite a bit of time, and when it comes back online, it's probably going to have changed its IP address. And we'll need to figure out what the new IP address is, so you can use the Ubiquiti device discovery tool to figure that out. So that's a Chrome extension or a Java program, whatever you prefer. So as you can see here, there's just a Chrome extension, so let's launch that app. So in the top right here, click on the Unify family button, and then click on find cloud key. And yes, it has changed IP addresses on me. But now that we've located the cloud key on the network, we can go to its web page and restore the backup file. So your old username and password will now have changed to the default of root and ubnt. So let's log in with that. And now you can change it back to what you were using. Now let's head to the maintenance tab. Oddly enough, reset to defaults didn't clear off the backups from my cloud key this time. Maybe it's the new firmware, but we'll restore now. So I'm stopping Unify. So once the Unify service stops, you should have the option of choosing a file. And after you click on choose file, navigate to the backup on your file system and open that. And then click on confirm. Invalid backup file, that's unfortunate. Okay, so that was panic-inducing, but I realized what happened. The reset to defaults command set me back, for some reason, an older Unify version. So now my backups have a newer Unify version than what the cloud key is running, so I need to synchronize things. So to do that, we're going to head back over to the SSH terminal, and we'll change into the temp directory. And then inside there, we're going to do a wget to download the latest Unify. So you need to go to the download section of the Unify website and look for the deb file for the Unify controller. And you're going to paste that link directly in here. And you're going to download that with the wget command. And now that that's saved, you can run the dpackage command with the I for install and give it the file name, unify sysv init underscore all dot deb. Let it do its magic. All right, so it's unpacked Unifi version 5.12.35, and now it's setting up that version. Okay, great, so now all the versions are synchronized, so we should be able to use our backups. But before we head out of here, let's clear out that deb file that we downloaded for the Unifi controller. So to do that, we just need to type in rm unify sysv init underscore all dot deb, hit enter, and now we can quit out of here. All right, now back in the Unifi controller once again, let's go back over to maintenance and look down for our latest backup file. But let's first stop Unifi. And let's restore this backup from the 17th. And cross our fingers. At this point, your cloud key should be restored into a working state with all of your settings. And I hope you found that this video helped you. And if you did, please click the like button down below. Leave me a comment, let me know how you did. And please consider subscribing to my channel for more great Ubiquiti videos. Thanks for watching.